short exhortation for us this morning. I just pray to be short, like I've said. Hallelujah. But it's just a way to remind us all that we have learned, all we have heard, all the teachings that we have heard, so that doesn't just sweep over us. Just a way to bring them back to us. Hallelujah. So the topic of the topic I put this is called the real battle. The real battle. Hallelujah. The real battle. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you this morning. There is no like you. The Bible makes me to understand that we can't separate you from your word. You are your word. The Bible says in the beginning was the Word, the Word was with God, and the Word was God. And Daddy, today we will be going into your Word. Daddy, release yourself unto us in Jesus' name. Give us a heart of understanding in the name of Jesus. Give us insight into the secret in the name of Jesus. Let our hearts receive it and let it work wonders in our lives. Thank you, Father. Every one of us will be blessed from your throne of mercy. Thank you because you are here in our midst. Blessed be your holy name. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. I said the topic is the real battle. And starting, I'm going to ask you, how many of us know that the Lord has given angels charge over us already all over this area? So I know I'm talking to the children of the Most High. And I know some people may begin to ask, how come angels, which one of them, which side? I've come to talk to you this morning. Hallelujah. Because we said the Lord has given charge over us already. We know that we are not talking by sight. Hallelujah. The Lord will help us in Jesus' name. I said you have had several teachings from God in the scriptures everywhere. How far are you applying it? How far have you applied it? Because when we last, about 2 weeks ago, the man of God talked about direction and talking about something, not having a mentor. And that is why he lost it. Have you applied it to your life and trying to guide yourself? If I quite remember, there are several teachings this January that talks about us having direction and leaning totally on the Most High God. If I recollect very far, I'm going to recollect by December, we're talking about having rest, or was it November? Having rest in the Lord. Now, how far are you walking in your life? How far are you putting those words together? I remember this January, the man of God talking about you do not sit in the seats of the scornful. How far are you applying it into your life? Because if we are not careful, we're going to just hear the word of the living God. It will just be the word. You know when you just receive it? And just like when the Bible says, it falls on the soil, yes. But because it did not mix with faith, it didn't find root. Therefore, the things and the situation of the earth decide to wear it away from their heart. So I want to really tell you, how far are you applying the word? Because the word can only work if you apply it to your life. Hallelujah. Okay, I also said, where are you not applying it? And what is the reason for not applying it? Are you telling me that a situation, there are situations that it cannot work? Is that what you are telling me? So if you are not applying it, why are you not applying it? Is there any reason for it? If there's a reason, is the one that you can talk out, it's better you decide to talk. But if the ones that you can't talk out, then you better decide it. And that's why I said the topic today is the real battle. The real battle. Hallelujah. There is a battle always going on between the seen and the unseen. There is always a battle going on between the temporary and the permanent. There is always a battle going on between the fact and faith. There is always a battle going on between our mind and our reasoning. There was also always a battle going on between our heart and our brain. Hallelujah. Because if you know that so well, then you know what I mean by saying the real battle. I ask, why are you not applying it? It's because battle is raging. It's at times we feel, is it my fault? Is it not my fault? I'm not saying it's your fault. I'm saying there is a battle going on. And just like a proverb, I'm trying to explain. It said, when two elephants are fighting, the grass suffer for it. So if there is a real battle going on between here and there, you as a human being, within that same principle, hallelujah. So there is a battle going on every time. Every time you desire a turnaround in a situation, you will hear a voice immediately behind you in your heart saying, it is going to happen. Oh, the way they said it. Ah, when the man of God is talking, they say, yes, it's going to happen. Ah, believe it. You hold on to it. You jump. It is going to happen. God can make way. Favor is coming. And you will see faith rising up in you immediately. But very soon, your head comes back and say, now, you have had that. Now give me the facts that is going to happen. What is the situation telling you? What are the principles? Can you give me logically what is going, how it is going to happen? Because if you remember in 1804, during the Habakkuk Macaulay, it never happened to them, even they are more learned than you. Or do you think you can ever be a prime minister in this country? The black have never been and can never be. I'm just telling you facts that was that your brain will place before you. If it had not been in UK, you just wait very soon. We've seen it in America. If it's happened once, it will happen again and again. Yes. They don't marry people like Kate before. Have you seen it happen? In your own very eyes. So the impossibility that you think will never happen, wait very little. I just pray that good things happen to you, because you will see it begin to happen. And you think, can it ever? Hallelujah. Amen. So it begins to tell you how facts come before you. You don't tell me about fat stuff. I don't know what you are believing or you are hoping. All I want is fact. The medical report comes to you and you look at it as if the doctor created the heaven and earth, as if the doctor created you. Now place it before you and tell you, do you think it will ever happen? God doesn't need to use stethoscope. He doesn't need to put you in the surgery room. He doesn't need you to do that. In fact, he doesn't need to come to you. He needs to just do what he can do. And before you know it, what the doctor said. Have you not heard that doctors, they've come around begging and apologizing that we thought it would never be possible? About somebody, they've told us that somebody cannot die for less than so in the brain will stop and everything. Have you two heard that somebody died over 1 hour and then after which he's come back to life and the brain is functioning right? The battle of life. At times, the way I say this, it's not your fault, but we only need to take care of that battle. Hallelujah. It tells us anything. It tells us where is your child now? Where is your baby now? The man of God prayed, yes, I know he prayed, they delivered, and he put leg, hand over you. Not so many things I tell you. And I say, no, where is that baby now? Where is that baby? And I now think, how old am I? Say, your father, did they tell you, is it in the this and this? Can it ever happen? Some people tell us that when you are old, over 50, can you ever marry again? But I've seen 60 married rightly. Hallelujah. The battle of life. They keep raging in our hearts and telling us it is never possible. You were once rich, you failed, yes. You did it wrongly, yes. And they tell you, in fact, you have just done it the right way. Because in 1804, Abraham Macaulay that did the same thing, mistake, he failed. So this that you have failed, you can never recover because you never recover. You better tell them, no. It's a battle of life. They give you instances. The things, that's why I said, the things you see. Fight against the things that are not seen. The things that are temporary, fight against the permanent. And they tell you it is never possible. You hear the word of the living God. You desire to apply it. Believe me honestly, your heart desires to apply it. But when the facts are placed before you, you now look at the facts and say, so that I don't look like a fool, it's better I believe what I can see. But have you forgotten that you are a physical body, but you're also spiritual? And the spiritual doesn't have to believe everything about the physical. You advance over them that do not know the Lord for one particular reason. You have two sides to live with. You are spiritual. So when the physical ties you down, lose yourself in the spirit. Lose yourself in the spirit. The real battle is taking place in our head. Hallelujah. Said, trust in the Lord. Look at this Proverbs 3:5 that we normally say. Say, trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding. It's telling us, lean totally in your heart. There's no battle in your heart. So don't think it's your heart. It's here that it's battle every time. The right things will come to your heart. Your heart is calm. It beeps calmly and that tells you, possible. And then your brain comes. I'm educated enough to know how I believe in it. I am this enough to think. I have seen enough. It begins to tell you, that is brain. But I have a question to ask you this morning. How do you know you have brain? Have you seen your brain before? Who said you have brain? Because until it begins to happen, they tell us that there is a woman that never have womb and deliver. They say, hey, so a woman can actually not have womb. That's when we start thinking. But also, is a woman can actually have womb? Everybody thought that every woman must have womb. Ask my grandma. She will never believe that there is a woman. If you're a woman, the reason why you're a woman is because you have a womb. But then science made us understand that there are women that do not have wombs. And at the end of the day, we believe that they should not have children. Science also countered it again and said, we have seen. Hallelujah. So I ask you, how do you know you have brain? Did you see your brain in the mirror? And we asked you to apply faith. You didn't apply faith, but you believe you have it because somebody told you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And sometimes we say faith. You know what? What did you apply? That is faith. Because it may not be there. Until science tells us that this man that never had brain and is walking there. So they can move without brain. You will soon see that again. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. But you believed. Praise the Lord. Amen. So the passage I read means that listen to your heart and turn off your reasoning. That's why it says, trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding. Turn off your understanding. And just trust God. Because you will soon ask me, is there God? I'm going to ask you again, just trust God. Say, God said something, let me just believe it. Hallelujah. Amen. Your mind will tell you all the reasoning why it will never happen. Soon you will walk yourself out of the possibility. All the facts are at times never give a logical conclusion. The meaning is that, let me tell you, when you reason everything together, what have you come to? Let me tell you, upon all the reasoning you've done in life, where have you come to a logical conclusion? I say, hey, I have this trouble. When I do this, that is the solution, okay? And you now went and you did the solution and went. It never. It will keep bubbling one trouble or the other. And when this happened, this is the implication. You will reason it physically, but it never. If a great God can heal you, you say, no, let me go to the doctor. So far has doctor ever healed you of the trouble? We said God can heal cancer. He said he cannot heal cancer. Will the doctor tell you he will heal the cancer?
No.
And we ask you to believe in the Lord with all your heart that he can do it. And you are doubting him that can't do it. And you are going after the person that can't do it. That will tell you, we only care. God does what? We only care. Hallelujah. Even the doctor that you are running to says it's God. Though. Even the one, the injection I gave is God. Unless I'm giving you a bad one instead of a good one. It's only God. Hallelujah. There's a story when we were younger, we heard of a woman. I don't know whether it's true. A friend of mine, we're all in secondary school, told me, so I can't verify the truth. But said her grandma was in the hospital. And so they all said that they should give her the injection for her to die peacefully because she can't do something. I wouldn't remember what she could not drink it. But they wanted to kill her in one word. Hallelujah. Give her an injection and allow her to. And so they actually administered the injection. They just gave her and just waited. So my mom just kept sleeping over here. These children started crying. She's going gradually. She's going gradually. She's still breathing. Doctor, is she breathing? Is she still? Until the woman now opened her eyes and went, I am hungry. And I was like, doctor, is hungry part of the death process? Doctor said, how can she be hungry? She's supposed to keep on dying. He said, come and see her sitting up. And he said, bring food. I have not eaten. Truly, mama had not eaten. So I have food. Is it like? So she came back to them and said, mama, doctor, you are bad. Why did you give me this injection all this time? You delayed me in pain all this time. Doctor, you are bad. Your mommy, come. Let me beat you because you didn't give me on time. But she was supposed to die. Hallelujah. Yeah. Trust in the Lord with all your heart. The injection was meant. The people of the earth, that your best friend, don't know you. He created you. So when we say apply faith, apply it. Apply the faith. the faith that we're asking you to apply is bigger than the situation you're looking at. When you apply faith, it looks, it seems there is no way. God, there is no way. Remember that when you get to a crossroad and there is no way again, remember God made way where there is no way. You know, to us these days, sometimes now when we read about the Red Sea, it's more of a fable to us than a reality. This is true that somebody parted. The one he parted Jordan and Red Sea the other time, why is he not parting it again? And because the white people, the people made bridge over water for you. That's hallelujah. If we have not been having the bridge, let me see if God will not part way. You know, it's a system when you go to that Darfur tunnel and you pass through the water, you think it is not parted. Hallelujah. But even if you're not seeing it physically, why not apply it spiritually? If you think, some of us don't believe in the Red Sea again, but God still parts. You go through a situation that seemingly look impossible. You look forward and backward. Look sideways, you are choked. That's why some of our friends go there and commit suicide because they feel there is no other way again. So they feel instead of going sideways, forward and backward, they feel like going up to heaven. Hallelujah. But there is always a way. There is, you can't catch our God, there is always a way. Hallelujah. How many of us believe there is God? That God is there somewhere. Then what is your father's work? You know, you feel he just sits in heaven, everybody is just fanning him. So they're letting him run me a star like this. And he's enjoying it. No. There's this God that is ever powerful. There is none like him. You know, so you find situations that people come to tell you, are you sure you're serving God? This church they're going, you better ask them to keep quiet. The atheists said there is no God. Truly they said it. But they acknowledged one thing. They said, if there is God, why then do we have all this problem in the whole world? I said, but you acknowledge there is problem. Then there must be something that someone that is the author of the problem. Hallelujah. Yes. Then that means that if you acknowledge there is an author of the problem, then that means that somebody is controlling somebody. Yes. Hallelujah. So we are grooming. Don't ever tell me nobody's controlling the world. Acknowledge there is a controller somewhere. Then I can tell you my father created good and evil. Hallelujah. Then I can tell you that if you say, how can God create good and evil? Then I will ask you to sit down again. I will tell you, if you say it's the devil that created bad, I will tell you that the devil that you think created the world trembled at the call of my father. Hallelujah. So somebody is greater than somebody. And so if my father can command the devil and the devil can stop, then who is in charge? So don't let anybody come back and tell you there is no God. Are you going to church? They're also deceiving you. They're also running. And so by the time you are thinking of your faith, by the time somebody talks beside you, you don't say, it's true. Don't you ever say it's true? I know it's never true. There's somebody controlling the universe. If not, if this world is not being controlled, then we are having a world that is just rolling about in chaos. And that is not true. If you are thinking of revolutionary, all this, they are, then this world is just moving. Then you are in trouble if nobody is controlled, it's just moving. Then we have no hope. But that's not true. Hallelujah. So have faith in God. Believe him that is controlling the heavens and the earth. He said, fear everything. If you don't need to fear anyone, fear me that can deal with the physical and the spiritual. Your father is a spiritual being. And that is why the eyes, simple eyes, cannot see what you are seeing. There was a time I was talking, I said, when you see somebody say, thus hear the Lord said, you want to ask yourself, is God still talking around? Is your father dumb? Is your father speechless? If you believe there is God, then he must be saying something. So if you don't hear God, you better begin to say, Father, I want to hear you. And don't say, just hear the Lord. They have started. What have they started? You are dead. You are a deaf child of your father. And that's the truth. Because God speaks. So have faith in God. Don't let the battle that rages in the heart take you away from the presence of your father. No, he loves you. Said Sarah, how do I explain the love of God? Said there's no greater love than this. There's no greater love. Hallelujah. Amen. He's a faithful God. We serve a supernatural God. Amen. We serve a supernatural God. God is not limited by the facts that you place before him. He's not limited. He controls the whole universe. He spoke this world into existence. Hallelujah. Amen. Is there anything you are? Is there anything that makes you think I am far behind? Can I catch up? One touch of God can bring you 50 years ahead. Yes.
That is God that we are. He's not limited by time. You have had instances of people that you, yesterday you look at them, today they are different. You have it already. Then why is your case different? Why are you thinking you are different? Or that is not going to happen? Why are you doubting it? One thing I've ever said, that God won't force you. You have to be said, he that will come to the Father must what?
Believe.
You have the first thing to do. You must first believe that I am, that he is. Before you even believe that he's the rewarder of them that diligently seek, before you think of the reward, first believe that there is God. He is. And that's why he called himself, I am that I am. Hallelujah. Don't ever doubt it. Don't let the facts that you have before you take you away from destiny. God has a good thought concerning you, the thought of peace and not of evil. He has an expected end for you. You didn't create your destiny. He created destiny. He knows why he's created you. So don't let the facts before you take you away from the purpose of the living God. Ah, no. Hallelujah. You know, one of the things that facts does, it dominates our reasoning. Dominates our reason, and the only way we can tap from God's supernatural help is to apply faith. I'm going to a point, because he wants to know, how do we apply faith? How do I apply faith? Faith, God is saying in faith, simply saying, trust me and just trust me. I don't need to make sense to you, because you can't reason me out. Describe God to me. You describe God to me. If I ask you to describe, it's going to be half two hands. Who told you he's got only two hands? Or he doesn't even have hands. Notice, he must have head. Who told you my God has head? Have you seen one before? Hallelujah. He's too mighty for you to explain. You can't phantom him. You can't see him in totality. If you know his side today, he will show you another side of him. We are talking about the Almighty God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. So it's too supernatural. You have taught enough. You have reasoned enough now. You have been reasoning, how is it possible? Is it this? I want you to say, stop right there now. Stop, stop. Stop where you are. God, are you going to do this? Will that be put to shame? Is there tomorrow? Is there future? Stop, just stop now. Stop. Am I going to ever get married, God? Nobody's going to stop where you are. Stop. Stop. Will I have that money? Will I build a house? Will I do this? Just stop. Ah, stop. Allow God, hallelujah. God is for you. If God be for you, who can be against you? Who means thoughts about the living things that you can see, that we think we are powerful than what? So if who cannot be against you, not even what can be against you. Hallelujah. God is greater than the forces that lay you back or make you feel that. He is too good. His goodness can turn you around. His mercy can set you free. His love can restore. He can give you a new beginning. Hallelujah. Yeah. Hallelujah. If you think more on facts, you are giving the facts the ability to be real. You're giving it an ability to be real. It's not there.
Amen.
How do you know that it's not there? Let me tell you. When my daughter, Ife was younger, Ife would watch the TV till about 1 midnight. And you know, when she was about 2 years old. And then she would gradually go to the room. You know, while we were thinking of watching over her, we would have dozed off a little, you know. And then, where's that girl? You know, I would now peek back downstairs. We're living in 2-story, downstairs to check her. She will not be there. And then we'll get to her room. My baby sleeping has covered herself. Plug this girl to the bed, switch off the light, and everything as if an adult has taken care of the whole thing. Tomorrow we'll say we'll check. Somehow we'll do something, you know. Because she's already there, we are going to work. But one day we made up our mind, we are going to watch this girl, myself and the daddy, hallelujah. And then as speechless as that girl was, when it was time, she would get up, she's ready to go, climb the table that was near the switch, off the switch, in the dark, she climbs the stairs. And off to her room, on her bed, cover herself, see you tomorrow. Myself and the lad said, is that Ife? You know, I'm like just an adult, walking in the dark. You won't believe that a child. But now she can't walk in the dark now because she's been watching all this monster thing. So monster. So that's a monster. I was like, this girl that used to work in darkness, where is the monster now? But you and I that are more matured than her, we know there is no monster anywhere in the house. Hallelujah. Yeah. Let me tell you another thing so that you know that those facts that you are seeing, they are not real. And there was a time in my life that if you say somebody is dead, by the time if a close person, if I'm walking later, maybe he died yesterday in the house, if anything does, boom, I come up. I assume that. In fact, I've heard that they said the dead ones come to visit the home. So I've just been, you should not come to visit home. Right. You know what happened when my younger sister died? And I just was crying, I just heard a sound. I turned back and I said, I know you are not there. That's not you. And I called that woman, you are not the one that is going to begin to make me afraid in the house. No, child of God, if you are there, it is not time for you to begin to scare anyone. I thought it's a time for you to go and sleep in the bosom of the Most High. You have done so well and brilliantly. Then why are you going all about if that is you? Go and rest, darling. Go and rest in the hand of your Savior. That was the first time and the last time. If I move and anything does in the back, I just wait. And then one day, something just happened. All of a sudden, there was a wind, there was wind. And the girl just goes, boom. Pastor just said, if we were in the village, they would say that's the ghost that closed the door, but there's wind outside for goodness sake. There's wind outside for goodness sake. Why did I bring all those ones out? The facts that you have before you, they are just fables to make you afraid. In the village, I have seen them pierce some of my friends' eyes before because their mother is disturbing them. The mother that was never there. They had to go and cut their eyes, you know, just you know they do in the village in no time. So they have marks for something that their father is never in existence. Darling, I can assure you that trouble has no power over your God. Don't let him make himself a God over you. He's not there. Now, if you think Deaconess Yemi is a lie, then I'll tell you that the same father that you serve is the one that created evil and good. So tell him to do you good and stop running about the work of his hand. Hallelujah. So stop running about. If you're seeing bad, then tell him, Father, you created good and evil, but do me good. Don't let me experience the bad. Instead of you still running up and down, hey, help me here, help me here. And the same person that created it that needs to help you is looking at you. Where will you run? Run. And you think he won't catch up with you. Hallelujah. God will help us in Jesus' name. The Bible says, I want to buttress a point that says, when two or more agree, it's Matthew 18:19, concerning a thing, it said establish. So when you agree with the devil about a fear, it shall be established. You have agreed. If you agree with fear, you have agreed. It's an agreement. So when you see a thing that you don't like, you better not agree. Agree only on the things of God. So when you begin to doubt, can it ever happen? I don't think it's going to happen. It's an agreement. It needs to be broken. It becomes like what, a vow. It becomes something binding. It becomes a covenant. So don't agree on the things that is not of God. Agree on the word of the living God. Hallelujah. Amen. And God will help us in Jesus' name. If anything is not adding up, you can't really click it together. Everything is looking troubled. All that we ask you is don't limit the God that you serve. When you hear the word of the living God, they say, I've had word of God today. How can I apply it? And the devil says, you've gone to, you know, I've had somebody tell me, you've gone to church and they have cajoled you again. I just looked back and said, you don't understand. And I just know you don't because you cannot understand the things of the Spirit. I understand because I live, like somebody that never lived in my village, I never come to Europe. I said, tell you, auntie, send money to me. Ah, after all, you people pluck money there. You and I that know better now. You know you are not plucking the money. But still tell them when you go home, and then especially when we are looking too good, and tell them, since I'm managing that place, the God of your management will visit us. That's what they will tell you. They can't believe it's true. But you that has lived between the two countries, you can experience better. You can talk better. Hallelujah. So if you're the spiritual being, in a physical being, you should know better than somebody that is in a village or is a physical being alone. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. There was a story of a man that the child was sick, one of the leaders in the synagogue, and then he called Jesus to come and help. And at the end of the day, Jesus, many things delayed Jesus on the way. You know the story. And somebody said, "Don't bother Jesus again. The child is dead." What did Jesus do? He ignored them. He just went on. And in case the person would be troubled, he looked back and said, "The child is not dead." Ignore. So if you have facts that are before you, they are true. The child died or not? The child died. It's dead. If I could touch, she would have been cold. They are facts, but they are not the truth. So Jesus said to him, just ignore the Lord. Don't bother master again. Don't bother master again. Hallelujah. And what did you say? He went there. I'm not saying that the situation is not there. I'm telling you it's a fact. It is not the truth.
Hallelujah.
It's just a fact. And so ignore it. When you want to celebrate the Lord, celebrate the Lord. Tell the devil it never happened. He's not there. If you want to pray, don't pray and be telling God every time. If God asks you to pray now, he knows what you are going to pray about. Before you say, "Your mother is in trouble of this," greet me first. Don't you know when children are coming to you and from the door, what do you even greet first? Greet me first. Well, because you know the problem is coming. Greet me first. Don't cry. Calm down. Now talk to me gently. Maybe God needs to be talking to us like that. Because immediately it's time to pray. Jesus, calm down. Greet me first. Worship me first. Adore me. Let me know that you are there. Hallelujah. And God will help us in Jesus' name. Don't go through the day and thinking about odd things. Some of us, when we woke up this morning, we go, "Hey, I'm going to that office. Jane will be there. That character can frown. Thomas will be there. Oh my God, that one can query." That's the first thing you think. And you just wish, "I wish today is just Friday, so I don't go to that office." Just start the day like that. James, Thomas, whoever they are, you will bow to me as I go. I'm a spiritual being. I'm walking in a mighty way. I command the old heart because God has handed it. Jesus said, this heart is not in the hand of the devil. He said, the key is in his hand. That's your big brother. Hallelujah. So the key is also in your hand if you know how to use it. Control the day, control the office. Control whatever comes to you. Settle it first and walk majestically into the office, including your enemy. Greet him. "Hello, darling, how are you?" You know when the enemy used to tell me, "It's got no choice. You know they have this plastic one. You definitely smile back to you." Hallelujah. "Oh, smile back." Hallelujah. Control the day. You are the child of the Most High. Hallelujah. God will help us in Jesus' name. God, facts don't stop God. Even the waves, even the mountains, they obey him. Let me allow us to read Psalm 104. So that it doesn't look you have not read it yet. Psalm 104. Psalm 104 from verse 4. I'm talking about your God. It said, verse 3, "The sea saw him and fled. Jordan was driven back. The mountains skipped like a ram, and the little hills like lamb." Hallelujah. And if you keep on reading, say, "What in it thou, O thou sea? Why did you draw back?" You know, asking several questions. We're talking about mountain to you is a stationary object, stone, a mighty one that is standing that cannot move. But before your God, they skip like rams. So that problem that seems unsurmountable, like a giant mountain standing there, can skip in the presence of Jehovah, the Almighty God. So I'm telling you, apply faith. Because there's a place in the Bible that you know and I know that without faith, it is impossible. It is very impossible for you to please God. So there's no way he can help you if you don't believe in faith. The only language of heaven or the things that operate in the spiritual realm is faith. That's the only thing that operates there. It's by faith. How do you know you are going to heaven? Have you been there and come out? Do you have the visa? Hallelujah. It's by faith. That's the only language of heaven. Everything you will do in heaven or you're thinking about heaven is by faith. Hallelujah. You look at it, ask yourself everything about heaven. Your future is by faith. Your tomorrow is by faith. Okay, let me ask you a question. Who told you that you are going to see tomorrow? Who told you? How do you know that you're going to see tomorrow? You have been applying faith, haven't you? That's assurance that you have tomorrow. He has only written it in your word with long life will that satisfy you. And you kept holding on to it. I believe God too. He has promised. So if you can apply faith for long life, why can't you apply faith for everything? Hallelujah. Because I know that it's only when something looks nice, nearly looking like long life, nearly look like physical. That's where most of us believe it. For example, you know, since I'm a baby, I'm going to grow. It's growing, so I can't. No, in everything, please apply faith. It can only work. Hallelujah. Amen. And God will help us in Jesus' name. Am I still with you, my thing? Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. I'm trying to make sure that I'm rushing. Sometimes fact is easier because it can be seen. The only reason why you believe fact is because you can see it. It is right before you. But don't forget in 2 Corinthians chapter 4:18, it says that the things that you see, they are what? They are temporary. But the things that are not seen, they are permanent, they are eternal. Hallelujah. And God said in his word, he said, for every of the arches, if you look that in Isaiah 61, it said, I'll give you beauty for ashes. That means he didn't tell you that there won't be that sorrow, there won't be that ashes. But I promised you that I will bring beauty out of it. So when you are facing a situation, everything is working out for good. Go and ask Mr. Joseph in the Bible. It's enough for a brother to deceive someone. Not only deceive, it's not enough for a brother to sell a brother. They were thinking of killing him. It's bad enough to know that your brother wants to kill you. Now, in the beginning, don't kill me, we won't kill you, okay? We can sell you into slavery and you will never return. It's enough for you every day in Egypt. It's enough for you to think every day, if my brother, Judah, this, if somebody tells you anything, if me mentioning Judah or Reuben beside you, you feel like cursing them. But many of us know that if you've never been in Egypt, you won't learn the principles of how to live in Egypt, talk less of leading in Egypt. So maybe the situation you are going through, and we ask you to apply faith, I say, please, please part of the journey to the promised land. Go and ask the great men that you have ever seen upon the surface of that. They will tell you a story in their life that you're going to open your mouth. Did you go through it? Maybe this is your own story that is going to a testimony. So then why are you running away? Why are you not applying faith? Hallelujah. Why are you not applying faith? Don't be like them. You are not them. If you are lonely now, it's a temporary situation and it's subject to change. Yes. Hallelujah. Yes. Your story has not ended. It is bound to change. What are you going through now? It has the ability to change. There's nothing. And that's why as a child of God, we keep praying so that we can sustain the good things that we have. Because if we are careless, it's bound to change. Everything on the surface of the earth that is existing in this world has the ability to change. And that's why we say, when you have a good in your hand, you better pray and hold on to the good. Because if you leave it for a while, it has the ability to change. But I can also tell you, if you have troubles in your hand now, don't worry. It has the ability to change. And it will change soon in Jesus' name. Amen. Don't let the fact convince you that it's going to go on forever. No, it's not going to go on forever. It's not. Hallelujah. You are about to see a change in Jesus' name. You have waited this long. It is enough. The Bible says you have encountered this for a long time. It's a time to progress. Hallelujah. It's a time for your testimony. It's a time for that breakthrough. It's a time for that unusual testimony. It is your season. It's a time of your celebration. In the name, you will be celebrated this year. In the name of Jesus. Ah, people will gather together and celebrate with you. In the name of Jesus. The Lord will cover that shame. He will cover that shame. You will not be ashamed. There is God. I must tell you, there is God. You're not serving God because He wants to ridicule you.
Hey, this is a Christian.
No. His name is at stake. There's this product that says, our name is on it. Have you heard that advance? Weeks, hallelujah. God's name is on you.
Hallelujah.
It's on you. Ah, it's ridiculous to God for you to fail. It's an abuse to His entity. Hallelujah. So He cannot. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I'm quickly round about. What I said is, I want you to bring those things you have learned back to your memory. God is able. He runs after His word to fulfill it. The word of the Lord, His life, God's life. Let me tell you, God's life is at stake over His word. The man of God, our bishop, will always say, the day God violates His word, He becomes a liar and is bound to die. And God can never die. So in words, we abide forever.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Don't let men deceive you. Why are you going to church? Don't mind them. Tell them I will mind everything. Hallelujah. It's all about God. Except if you are here to see anybody. Anyway, I'm here always to serve God. That's why I run my race. I won't mind whatever anybody is saying. I run my own race because I am convinced beyond all reasonable doubt that I serve a living God. So don't let anybody talk about you. I'll talk less about the church for you. I'll talk less about this. Don't say, even you, they talk less about you. Go, put your hair. You will see people talking about you. In fact, you will wonder, do you exist? The way people talk about you. So when they talk about church or talk about God, just leave them. They will talk about everything, won't they? They will. So what are you running after? You have to, just tell them, it's about, what are you talking about? They said some churches, just move away. Don't be part of them. Don't sit in the seat of the slanderers. Don't. Did you hear that pastor committed it? I mean, move away. Because your kingdom is not like that. Your father is not like that. There are several children of darkness that pretend to be light. I don't care, but I know about the light. So I'm not interested in what you tell me that the kingdom of darkness is there. Don't come and tell me the story of the kingdom of darkness. Stand with the Lord. If nobody is for the Lord, can you arise for Him? If they tell you that the whole Christian, the whole world, they are all fake, can we not find you to stand for Him? A man of God in the Bible said, God, I'm the only Christian, I'm the only pastor, I'm the only one that is of Lord. God said, what? And I see several that are standing for Him. So whatever they talk about the kingdom of the Father, don't bother yourself. You and I, we are still standing for Him.
Amen.
If you still need a soldier for the Lord, if you don't see any, I can point to myself. I can never deny God. God has been faithful enough. Hallelujah. Can I see that in you? Can I see that of you? Have faith in God. He said, if He tarries, what did He say you should do? He said, wait. If He's making a promise for you and He says He's delaying, wait. He said it Himself. He said, but at the appointed time, He will show. Hallelujah. God is good. God is good. I want you to apply faith like never before. And don't listen to the things that will discourage you. Facts are for a short time. Facts are for a short time. But the faith in our God is eternal. So whatever you hear as a word from the throne of mercy, hold on to it and don't doubt in your heart. It doesn't have to make sense. Because your sense can't even comprehend God in the first instance. So it doesn't have to tally with your sense. If it is God, go for it. Hallelujah. And rounding up, I will tell you a story in the Bible of a man, supposedly an unbeliever. Let me put that with the king, wanted to marry Sarah, Abraham's wife. But Abraham lied and said, that's my younger sister. And obviously he married, wanted to marry. And so they took Sarah from him. Normally, he made all necessary things. He blessed Abraham, like the big brother to the younger one. Gave Abraham animals and things like that. But God appeared at night. Said, who are you touching? Where,
Come. Who is that one? I love the answer. I'm going somewhere by saying the answer the man gave. He said, Lord, in the integrity of my heart, I do not intend to take somebody else's wife. In integrity, he told me that the younger sister, God, you need to tell me the story very well, because what I meant to understand, in the integrity of my heart have I done this. And God said, I understand it because of the integrity of your heart, that's why I have come. If not, I could kill you. I'm going somewhere. Even if you sin, even if you've done something, but the totality and integrity of your heart as a child of living God, your father doesn't sleep for you to fail. He will return to you and tell you, no, don't do it that way, darling. Come back. That's not the right thing. So don't let everybody begin to run after the evil and say, ah, since everybody is running, I want to run. You stand. Even if you are supposed to run, if God wants you to run, he will return back to you and say, darling, speed off. Let God direct you. Let God know that you are standing for him. He will never leave you nor forsake you. Let everybody do it wrong, stand right. The man of God, pastor, will always say, you can never be wrong doing the right thing. Apply faith. It works. And faith works. And don't let the facts tell you otherwise. We serve a faithful God. Hallelujah. So rise up and just tell God how much we love him. Let's tell him how much we appreciate him. Let's talk about the battles that have been raging in our heart and tell God to help us solve this battle. It's a battle of life, the facts and the truth. You know, the fact and the faith that we need to apply. Start telling us, it's not possible, it's not possible. I want you to be sincere with your father and say, Father, I didn't want to believe the wrong thing, but they look more real to me. But Father, I come to you now so that I can apply faith and do it exactly, so that the word can be useful in my heart, so that the word can be good to me, that I can do the word of the living God, that I can do the bidding. And I pray, Father, wherever I've doubted you, prove that you are God so that I can stand right. Hallelujah. Tell God I need a testimony to convince me. I need you to intervene so that I can stand more strong for you. I need you to touch me again, oh Lord, in a new way. That if you can do that miracle, I will not doubt, I will stand stronger. Hallelujah. Tell God to do something that will make you strong for him. That will be your testimony forever for people to know that there is God in heaven. Tell God to help you. Hallelujah. Tell God to help you. Hallelujah. We bless the name of the Lord. Thank you, Father. In the name of Jesus. I want us to agree together this morning. All those things that has troubled us, really, that remain facts before us, that we nearly not apply faith together, I want us to declare all together that today there shall be testimony concerning them. In the name of Jesus, everything that remains a fact, that remains a fact and is affecting our faith, today we ask it shall turn to testimonies. In the name of Jesus, there shall be healing in the house, instant healing from the Most High God. In the name of Jesus, there shall be opening of the wombs, there shall be deliverance from the Most High, there shall be release of financial blessing. Everything that has faced us like giants, that makes us look as if our God, can you help us? Today we stand together as your children, oh God, we say turn into testimonies for us. In the name of Jesus, we want to return thanking you. We want to return thanking you. We want to return thanking you. That is making it a covenant for us. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we pray. That in many facts has made us cry. Facts before us, they make us cry. But I want to tell you, God, your Father knows you cry. He said upon his hand, he carries your tears in his hand. Hallelujah. He sees those tears. Tonight, today, I want you to pray. Let those tears turn back to the tears of joy. I want you to declare it concerning everyone. Concerning my brothers, my sisters in the household of faith. I want you to declare to the Lord. It shall turn to testimony. It shall turn to testimony. We will not serve the Lord in vain. We will not serve the Lord in vain. It shall turn to testimony. We have delayed enough. We have been delayed enough. It's time to move forward. It's time to progress. In the name of Jesus. This is our season, it is our time. Hallelujah. It cannot be taken from us. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In the name of Jesus. Bible says, seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. and everything shall be added unto you. But I bet you we are seeking other things and not seeking the kingdom of God. I want you to pray. Father, help me to stand strong for you. Develop me spiritually. Make me stronger. Release your anointing afresh upon my life. Go ahead and speak to the Lord. Everything that will make me a Christian, endow me with it. Everything that will make me stand for you, endow me from above. I ask for spiritual giftings from you. I ask for spiritual impartation from you. In the name of Jesus, I ask for freshness from above. In the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you. Your word has come to us expressly, Jehovah. We acknowledge you are the Almighty, the great God, the I am that I am. You are the immortal, the invisible, the only wise God. You are everything to us. You are the one that words are not enough to express your entity. You are beyond words. Thank you, Father, today. That is there any way fact? We have experienced real battles in our heart. The battles that presents facts to us. That is today we agree together. He said, whatever we bound on earth is bound in heaven. That which we lose on earth is loose in heaven. Today we release those testimonies for us. In the name of Jesus. Those facts turn to testimonies now. In the name of Jesus. These facts turn to testimonies now. In the name of Jesus. Turn to testimony now. In the name of Jesus. Devil, you have lied long enough. We ask that the truth of the Lord begin to prevail. The truth of Jehovah begin to prevail in the name of Jesus. That if you give us these testimonies we have cried upon, then we can have something tangible to hold on and say, of the truth, the Lord has helped me. That he give us these testimonies. Give us these testimonies. Give us these testimonies. Give us these testimonies in the name of Jesus. We thank you for safe deliveries for our women that are pregnant already. But we thank you for others that are getting pregnant now. New wombs are opening. Seed of the Most High entering in the name of Jesus. Championing will not cease in our midst. In the name of Jesus. I pray for everyone that has experienced one thing or the other in your business line. It seems you have failed, but I speak to you today, you have not failed. The Lord will turn it around in your favor. It is your time to celebrate in the name of Jesus. The Lord will remember you for good. In the name of Jesus. I don't know where you want me to pray for you, but I know God has healed you. I know God has healed you. In the name of Jesus, I know God has healed you. He's Jehovah Rapha. He's a healer. He has healed you in the name of Jesus. Wherever anyone here needs prayers, Lord, you are the one that normally prays for us. So we're so used to you doing that. Jehovah, pray for us. Amen. Do that which we ask of you in the name of Jesus. All we ask today, glorify yourself. Prove that you are God. Let us return. They have table facts before us, but let us return to them with testimonies in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name.